In this video, we're going to show you a great concept of how you can choose to paint your army, and that is an army of animated stone statues. This works particularly well for Warhammer Age of Sigmar, where magic runs rampant in the mortal realms, and for a theme, you could, for example, have your general be a sorcerer who's animating the whole army of these stone statues and is the only model painted in the normal way. But if you want to do this, and you want to paint your models like this, then what you should do, first of all, once you've built them, is take your clippers and start chipping away at them a little bit, which you can see is what I've done with my Stormcast Sequitur model example here. Cut to the shield a few times around there, and a bit of the crest on top there as well to give the impression that the stone is flaking away and chipping away. Now, once done that, the colour to undercoat the miniature with is Mechanica Standard Grey, and then what we're going to do is start out by dry brushing the miniature using Dawnstone. Then we're also going to dry brush it using Rakarth Flesh, and these dry brushes will bring out the detail of the miniature, and the Rakarth Flesh will allow us to start adding a different tone to the stone on the miniature as well to focus on certain details. But first of all, we need Dawnstone, and I'm going to be applying this using a medium dry brush. And with this kind of paint, what you should do is just get some of that paint onto the bristles, get some tissue and work it into the brush like this and get rid of the excess paint. And once you've done so, what you've got to do is start brushing the brush back and forth across the texture of the miniature. So quite lightly like this, and you'll see the colour catches on the raised areas and details. And it can be as heavy here as you like. It really depends on what shade of grey you want the miniature to be. Once you're happy with the Dawnstone, we're then going to move on to dry brushing using Rakarth Flesh applied to the small dry brush. And what this is to do is to provide a second tone to the stone to make the model a little bit more visually interesting. Now, it's entirely up to you which parts you do here, but what I'm looking to do is to pick out areas such as the robes, some detail on the shoulders, and some detail on the shield as well. And you can see I'm just taking my time and being careful, slowly building up the colour in the areas where I want it to be. I've finished building up that second tone for the stone now, so we can move on to the next step, which is to add some shade to the miniature to really give it some depth and help that detail stand out. Now, at this point, we're actually going to use two shades at the same time. We're going to use both Agrax Earthshade and also Athonian Camo Shade, because Agrax Earthshade will give a nice earthy appearance to it, being a brown shade, but Athonian Camo Shade will give a slight mossiness to it, so perfect for ancient statues. So first of all, I'm going to be applying some Agrax Earthshade, and I'm going to do it using the medium shade brush. And I'm just going to begin by getting some of this ready, just checking how much I've got loaded on my brush by using a palette like this. But to begin with, all you have to do is apply a good amount onto the miniature anywhere you want. So I'm going to start around about here. Now, as you're applying this at random intervals, instead load some Athonian Camo Shade on your brush and just start painting this on next to it like this. And just allow the paints to mix together where they meet, because you see this way you get a random effect where some areas the model will be slightly more green and some areas slightly more brown. It gives a really nice natural finish to the miniature. With that shade completely dry, we can now move on to the next stage, which is first of all to dry brush across the entire miniature using Terminata Stone, which will highlight all the stone and bring all the different tones together. Then after that, we're going to apply some more Athonian Camo Shade, but in a very selective way this time to really finish off that mossy effect of the stone. But first of all, we need Terminata Stone, which I'm going to be applying using my medium dry brush. And we want to dry brush just like we did earlier by getting a small amount of this paint onto the brush, then using the tissue to get rid of the excess paint like this. And we want this to be a very light dry brush, so really make sure that you get rid of most of the paint on the tissue like this. And once you've done so, what you need to do is just do a light flicking motion across the entire miniature like this, so the colour just catches on the sharpest edges and corners. And then we're ready to reapply some small amounts of Athonian Camo Shade. Now this time I'm applying it using a small layer brush, and what I'm looking for is areas where water would collect on this statue when it's standing still. So for example, just in there like that, so it becomes a bit greener in those areas and therefore looks a little bit mossier. And with that, we've now finished the stone and we're ready to move on to adding a more magical effect to the miniature with a form of a blue glow. And for this, what we're going to do is paint around the eyes and also some of the runes that are on the maul head. Now, to do this, we need to start out with Drakenhof Nightshade to give the hint of a blue around those areas. And then we're going to put in a much stronger blue using Araman Blue first of all, followed by Baharoth Blue. But to begin with, we need Drakenhof Nightshade, and I'm going to be applying this with the small airbrush because we don't need very much of this. So use your palette to help out with that to make sure your brush isn't overloaded. Just get rid of the excess paint off there like that. And then what we're looking to do is to paint this around the area where that blue glow is going to be. So the eyes are a great example here. What I'm going to do is just paint some of this around the edges like that to give a subtle hint of blue and make sure it goes into the recess of the eye socket as well. Now for the runes that are on the maul head back here, I'm going to be doing the exact same thing, making sure the shade is completely in the recessed area, but also I'm just going to bring some of it around the outside to give that hint of blue light as well. Once that shade is dry, you're then ready to move on to Araman Blue, still with a small airbrush. And what we're going to do here is to paint this directly into the recess of these areas that are going to be glowing, and just bring the colour up to the very edges so that you've got a hint of that blue on the highest areas going around the outside there like that. And the exact same is true on the runes and the weapons. We just want to paint the whole of the recessed area and just catch the outside edge as well. And with that done, you're then ready to finish off with a small amount of Baharoth blue painted into the very deepest recesses of these details. Now, once you've done this, you're then ready to base your miniature. And for this, we recommend avoiding Astro Granite, because if you go for a grey base, it'll blend in too much with the miniature itself. So you want to avoid that. For my miniature, I'm going to be using Sterling Mud and then adding lots of grass tufts to make the ground look really overgrown. I've now painted the base and added some grass tufts to it as well. And with that, this animated statue is complete. So if you decide to paint your miniatures using this method, there's a few things to bear in mind. The first is that it's a good idea, before you undercoat it, to just chip the miniature a little bit so you've got some cracks in the stones. When you paint it, it's some real nice texture for the paint to pick up on. Also, when you're dry brushing it, be sure to slowly build up the colour rather than applying a lot at once, because this way you get a nicer, smoother result. But there you go, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found this idea interesting, and we'll see you all again soon.